was to be their holiness of living. And the sign of their holiness of living was to be these rituals. So we cannot condemn the Pharisees for being just casually hypocrites, because in fact they were doing what they thought was a very good thing, raising up a sign in the world of holiness, raising up a people that said, we will not be defiled by the Roman Empire, we will be a holy people committed to God for all time. But that's not Jesus' response, is he? Is it? Jesus' response is, you hypocrites. And like so many exchanges between Jesus and others, it's almost as if he takes a question and he turns it on its head. Because when Jesus looks at this issue of washing hands, he looks at it from another perspective. Not from inside the Jewish people, though he is a good Jew and he probably kept all of the good Jew things that you did in the tradition. But he looks at it from outside that, and what he sees is that the sign of washing your hands has become merely a ritual, and it has become merely something else. It is no longer something which points to the holiness of God's people. In fact, it sort of covers up the unholiness of God's people. Because from his perspective, doing all these holy things is a cover for having lost the essential part of God's commandment, which is love, which is justice, which is reconciliation. He accuses the Pharisees of clinging to a tradition, but not clinging to the commandment of God. And the commandment of God is, you shall love the Lord your God with all your heart and soul, neighbor as yourself. He turns it so that you cannot, there can be no mistake that you are somehow achieving salvation by what you do, by who you are, by what group you belong to, by what rituals you do. He turns it and he says, no, that's not what the issue is. The issue is your heart. Your to love God and to love your neighbor. That's what the heart of the matter is. And anything that you do that covers that up, that changes the subject, that points to other people and says they should be doing something, or points to some idea that there's an in-crowd and an out-crowd, anything that points to any of that is the darkness. That's the pride, the darkness that comes from within. So he says, the things that defile us are the things in our heart that keep us from loving. Envy, pride, anxiety, all the things that keep us from the simplicity of open hearts, beyond measure, loving God in thankfulness, loving ourselves, loving our neighbors. It's those things which keep us from doing that, which defile us. And so we come back again to the beginning. The point of this gospel lesson this morning is that anything that keeps us from loving God, loving our neighbor, defiles us. Anything that we claim beyond that, anything that hardens our hearts in the slightest, defiles us. This is an intimate struggle. we are deceived by our inner selves.
We know